After John Lennon returned to Yoko Ono, she gave birth to their son in October 1975. They gave up public life. John stayed at home to take care of Sean, while Yoko discovered a new passion, the business of the booming Lennon empire.
If I sang in a song.
Life is what happens to you while you're busy making other plans.
Sean was four when his parents emerged from their reclusive lifestyle and began writing music together. The launch of their album, Double Fantasy, put them center stage once more.
I felt that, or John and I felt that we were doing everything right in a way. Arrogance maybe, but we felt that finally we were doing things right. It was a time when we were very exposed because of Double Fantasy. And it was very strange because I kept having this kind of flash of John being kidnapped. And I said, just please be careful, you know, because things like that could happen too, you know. So naturally, we felt a little bit scared.
Goodbye, 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 my love. It's time to say goodbye.
The shooting happened just after Lennon and his wife Yoko stepped from a chauffeured car after returning from a recording session. The killer shouted his name, then fired five shots at close range. Cradled in the arms of his wife Yoko...
It's important that people remember that Yoko was there. Yoko heard the gunshots, saw her husband fall, saw the glass of the door shatter and splatter, saw the blood, heard the siren, and saw her partner and her lover fall to the ground.
When I was in the hospital, I was at the hospital, and the doctor came and said, now you have to tell the people, because I think the radio show and press, and they were all wanting to know. And you have to tell, you know, could we announce it? I said, please wait. Why wait? But I felt like by announcing it, it really becomes the truth, you know? And I just wanted a little while longer for John to be around, you know.
Yoko did tell the world of her husband's death, but it took another 24 hours for her to break the news to their son.
I just didn't have the heart to face Sean and say, Sean, what are you going to say, Sean? What? Finally, I said to Sean's nanny, please tell him to come to my room.
I have a memory of walking into the bedroom at the Dakota. My mom's sitting in bed. Sitting up in bed. I remember seeing like a newspaper to her left, which somehow in my mind is a headline about my father being killed. I remember my mom saying, your father's dead.
And Sean said, oh, mommy, but you know, you're still attractive and beautiful, so you'll get somebody else, don't worry. And I was saying, oh, that's what it meant to him, okay. You know, I'm relieved, you know. And then I found out that he went back to his room and he was crying. And so, you know, they told me that, crying. But he didn't want to show tears to me. He just wanted to tell me that I'll be all right, you know.
You're a beautiful boy with all your little toys. Your eyes have seen the world.
In the days and weeks that I spent with her, she rarely spoke, hardly ate. She was inconsolable. It was the darkest of times.
It's like you ask somebody who was in a plane accident and she survived and everybody else died or something, and how did she manage to come out or something? I mean, I don't think she knows. I think she just does it, you know? And that's how I was. I just tried to, I feel like I was in a deep water. And I just wanted to get to the top to breathe.
I remember my relationship with my mom kind of beginning on some level, or my real relationship with her beginning at that point. And we became a lot closer, obviously. And I felt in some way like I was, you know, being introduced to her for the first time at that moment, because she had kind of played a secondary role until then. It was kind of like a tornado when my dad died. And so we really kind of held on to each other and became very close.
My mom here. I've been asking her since I was about three, I think, if I could come here, and she'd always say, you'll go in a couple of months and stuff like that. So I'd say, okay, in a couple of months, and I've never went, and this is the first time I've been here, and I feel great.
Yoko started to rebuild her life, beginning a new relationship with Sam Havatoy, her antique dealer, whom she still lives with today.
It's amazing that I came out of it. But now I feel that with all that experience, that I'm going to start a new life. That's how I feel about it. And I don't know how it's going to be, but probably that's how it's going to be. Did I make myself clear?